Next question is from LT Fitness Training. Define fitness.
I can't, because that's like it's like defining love. It's for every person, it's different, man.
Yeah, what's one person considers fit esoteric. May not be fit for someone else. Like a bodybuilder might be very fit for their workouts, but would be terribly unfit for running a marathon or swimming, a few laps or whatever. You really can't define fitness. I like saying something like health. Health might be a little bit better, in which case I would say you have some longevity, you can move freely, you don't have any pain, you've got good blood lipid levels, you've got good insulin response to food, you've got decent energy throughout the day, hormones seem to be pretty balanced. But fitness is so specific, and really this is something you have to define for yourself. If you want to be able to play with your kids, go on the occasional hike, like the way you look in your clothes and just generally feel good, then your fitness goals are very different from someone who wants to, max deadlift or whatever.
I totally look at it more as a ability, maintaining or improving abilities and an overall function and capacity of the human body. So whatever that looks like for the individual, it's going to vary. And that's why it's such a hard thing to nail down and define exactly what it is. But, from my perspective, it's if I have a goal or pursuit that's physical, it's really like the fitness is the process to get you there, or it's like something that you're constantly adopting and considering in your everyday practices. Mm.
So now that we've covered how I think we all agree that this is, it's hard to define this. Now, do you guys have your own personal, like what you think?
I was just going to ask that.
Yeah. Like general fitness. So like for me, we talked about this actually on a recent podcast where, I have a certain amount of weight that I feel like for those actually the big lifts that we just talked about that I want to be able to do. And to me, that's what being fit is for me. Like I know I'm not anywhere near my max lifts on all those. That's okay. I don't need to be that fit in all those areas. I want to make sure that I'm also not weak in all that stuff. And same thing goes for even cardio. Like, by no means could I get out there right now and run 3 to 5 miles and do great at it. But if I could run a mile, I could run a mile right now and I could do a decent amount of time. And so I have like markers that if I can't get under a mile under 9 minutes, I'm starting to get out of shape in that area. Like that's not fitness to me in that area. So I need to get better at my cardiovascular endurance. If I'm not able to, bench work out with 225 on bench, I know that I'm starting to lose my strength in that area. If I can't deadlift more than 400 pounds, I know that I'm losing my, and so to me, as long as I'm kind of staying, and then mobility wise, right? So if I notice sometimes I'll get down, I haven't been in my 90-90 in a while, and I'll get like, I'll cramp just from being in the 90-90. So I know that I'm neglecting my hip mobility. And so I kind of have all these little things that I check in with myself, and I have markers for me that I say, okay, I'm pretty fit. I'm fit. I'm healthy. I'm good. I like where I'm at. Sure, I can be better in all these things, but I don't want to allow myself to go below that because then I feel like my fitness is suffering. But that's so individual, right?
For me, it's like I want to be able to work out, feel good in my workouts, get a good pump. I want to be devoid of major pain, aches and pain, so I feel like I can move. I want to feel like I could go on a hike because that's something I enjoy doing when the weather's nice. I like to go on hikes. I like to feel like I have a good libido, and I like to feel like I have good, sharp energy. My job involves obviously being on a podcast or being on other podcasts or doing media. And if I notice that I start to feel a little foggy or not quite as quick with my comments or my thoughts, then I'll start looking at my diet. I'll start looking at my sleep and my exercise because I want to feel very sharp. So for me, fitness means feeling sharp, feeling pretty strong, and otherwise just feeling healthy and like I can go on hikes.
Yeah, I think too, it's where you are in life. For me, it was different when I was like trying to get as much out of myself as I could in my athletic pursuits and, trying to PR. And I think it's evolved now to a lot of what you're talking about in terms of being pain-free, having energy to keep up with the kids and actually like have that movement where I can be explosive. So being explosive, I think as I'm aging, is really a high pursuit for me. I want to, because that that identifies to me if I have mobility issues or if I have any kind of pains or like the patterns throughout my day are limiting my abilities. I want to address those things. And so for me to jump and to, move quickly left to right and twist and do all these types of things, to play basketball, to throw a ball, to kick a soccer ball, to run, it really is like heavy emphasis on movement now more than ever. But I do agree. I try and keep certain lifts in mind. Like I don't want to lose my strength. I still want to be able to squat, somewhere around what I used to squat. And I want to keep those abilities. I want to be able to deadlift. I want to be able to bench. I want to be able to overhead press. And so I keep those, a constant check on those things.